Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. We are back with another science story called Mary Smith. And believe it or not, the humble pea is going to take center stage. The book Mary Smith is a book about Mary Smith. She was an actual person who lived in the 1920s, and she was basically the alarm clock of the 1920s. How did she wake people up? Well, before they had alarm clocks, Mary Smith would walk around town and she would use peas and a little pea shooter to shoot peas at people's windows to wake them up. And we thought this was the ultimate STEM challenge and the ultimate shout out to Mary Smith to make our own pea shooter. As far as materials go for your pea shooter, you're going to need a straw, a wooden skewer, a rubber band, and some tape. Now, when you buy a bag of wooden skewers and lay them out, you'll find that some of them are actually curved or crooked. And to make our pea shooter, we want to find the straightest one possible. So I'm going to go with this one. And now we need to make it safe by snipping off the end so nobody gets stuck by that sharp end. We're good to go. So here's how the pea shooter is going to work. The wooden skewers put through a hollow straw, and you can see this rubber band is going to provide the energy that when I stretch it, it has enough force to push out the pea out the front. We load the pea in the front here, this little funnel. I'm going to pull back and it shoots it. So the first step is to attach the rubber band to the wooden skewer. I like to stretch that rubber band out and make it a little bit more flexible. Once I do that, I'm going to take one end of the skewer and drape the rubber band over it and pull back so that that rubber band's going to stay in place. I want to make sure it's pretty well centered on the skewer, and once I have that, I'm ready to tape the end of the rubber band onto the skewer. Now it's easiest to stretch the rubber band just a little bit because it helps keep it straight. I want to have a little bit of the skewer rubber band showing at the back end. And now I like using electrical tape because I can pull and stretch this very, very tightly. This is also going to create a stop, which prevents the skewer from going all the way through the straw. So I want to put a few wraps on this so I know it's going to stop. And then snip it. And I have it attached. Next comes the straw. And we've found that bendy straws are actually perfect for this because the skewer's going to be slamming into the end of the straw repeatedly. The straw could split. This nice little bendy part becomes a nice little shock absorber. So I'm going to snip the straw just in front of the bendy part. And now let's test it out to see that the skewer slides through. Yep, nice and easily. Now we need to attach the rubber band to the straw for our energy. I'm going to be attaching the rubber band to the straw, and there's going to be a lot of force on that rubber band and straw attachment as I pull back. So it could possibly slip through. So we need a little stopper knot on the end of the rubber band so that it won't pull through the tape that I'm going to use. It's a little tricky tying this. You want to pull it tightly so it snugs up. Now I'm ready to put on the straw, thread it onto the wooden skewer, and now I can hold the rubber band with the straw and tape around that. All right, we're ready to tape this. You want to make sure you're not taping the rubber band onto the skewer and just wrapping it around the straw. You do not want to pull too tightly because if you crush the straw, the skewer will not be able to slide freely through the straw. So I want to pull a little tightly, but not too tightly. I like to go around quite a few times. It's going to prevent the straw from splitting, and it's going to hold the rubber band. I like it. Snip it. Now let's see if we have, yes, we have the force and energy of our pea shooter ready to go. Now at this point, our pea shooter is pretty difficult to hold. We're going to be holding up on this end of the straw, and it's a little flimsy and we want something easier to grip. So now I'm going to wrap some tape around this upper part. It's going to keep the straw from collapsing onto the skewer and give me something to grab. So in this case, I'm going to be using this kind of tape. So when taping my little grip, I do not want to put it all the way at the top because we are going to be attaching a little cone or funnel that's going to hold the little peas that we'll be shooting. So let's just start wrapping this around, trying to keep it as straight as possible. I like to roll the straw and skewer it's easier to keep it straight. It's up to you how many times you want to go around or how big or thick you want your little grip to be. That should be good. Test it out. It should feel comfortable in your hand. It seems like it'll work. So now we can see how our pea shooter is going to work. We pull back the skewer. We could load a pea at the top of the straw, but it's pretty difficult to hold this, load the pea, let go. Let's see, balance the pea. Let's see if I can get this one to work. It doesn't work well, so I need some kind of funnel at the top to hold the peas, extend past the skewer, and allow me to easily pull back and aim and fire at a window. Here we go. The next step is making a nose cone that extends over the skewer and the straw, and it allows me to load the peas into the nose cone and fire. So how do we make this? That's the next step. Now, there are certainly many ways to make a cone. This technique is something we developed at Fun Science Demos. We're gonna use a square piece of paper, and all I'm going to do is to put two diagonal lines right through my square. One, two. Next, I'm going to take a scissors and cut one little triangle out of that square. Now I'm ready to make my cone. Now there's a little trick to making our nose cone here. So I'm gonna take this edge, I'm gonna start to twirl it over, to twist it around and line it up with that line. Just like that. I'll do it one more time so you can see. This edge is gonna be lined up with this line. And to do that, I have to twist it. Now you can see my nose cone sort of take shape. Now, all I have to do is wind this up around the rest of the paper. Can get it perfect. I'm gonna take a stapler and put two staples in, and I have my nose cone. The next step is snipping off the end of my nose cone so it slides over not only my skewer, but my straw, and then we're gonna be attaching it right at the top of the straw. You wanna be careful not to snip too much off the first time, so it's kind of a guess and check. That's a little too small to fit over the straw, so let's give that a shot. Goes over the skewer, no problem. Take your time. You don't want this too big to get it just right over the straw. A little too small. Let's take a little bit more. Let's see if that works. Take your time and get it right. Yep. That's gonna work just nicely. Now I need to tape my nose cone into place, and I think we'll be ready to test it out. So we've used tape to secure our nose cone to the end of the straw. If the straw is sticking up too far, the peas won't be able to seat down at the bottom of the nose cone, and you won't be able to fire. Now I think we're ready to test out. We're gonna start by loading one pea at a time into our nose cone. I'll pull this back. I'll give it a little shake to make sure the pea is down at the end of the straw, and we'll test it out. 3, 2, 1. I think the pea exploded. Let's try another one. Seems to be shooting a little to the left, so I'm gonna aim. Pretty good. Now we've used peas because, well, Mary Smith used peas, but you could try anything on your own. You could use little balls of tin foil or mini marshmallows or gummy bears or Skittles or M&Ms. Anything should work. We'd like to give a huge shout out to this great book, Mary Smith, which was the inspiration for this awesome STEM challenge. If you'd like to learn more STEM challenge ideas, check out our YouTube channel, Fun Science Demos. Science is so cool, especially when you can launch something across the room. Thanks for watching.